Hello everyone. So we are all hearing about this OpenAI. So what is an OpenAI? So OpenAI is an artificial intelligence platform which enables developers to build, train, and deploy AI applications. And what is Postman? Postman helps team to create a unified workflow from development to production by providing easy-to-use collaboration tools that enable teams to quickly develop, test, and document monitors and share APIs. So by integrating OpenAI with Postman, organizations can swiftly develop sophisticated AI applications that are easily monitored, tested, and shared. Hello everyone, this is Sudipto from Technical Potpourri and welcome to my channel. I'm dedicated to bringing you the latest news, insight and tips on cloud technologies, web frameworks and APIs. If you haven't done yet, please go ahead and subscribe to my channel so that you will be notified every time I publish a new video. Without any further delay, let's find out how to integrate OpenAI and Postman. The first thing that you need to do, you need to go to this openai.com and click on API. Here you need to create your own account. I've already created my account, but it's very easy. You click on sign up and then give all the details like your email address, or you can continue with your Google. So since I've already created my OpenAI account, I'll just go ahead and click on login and continue with my Google. So here I am on my OpenAI overview section. So the first thing that I need to do to build an integration is to create an API. For that, I'll click on this personal and go to view API keys. I've already one key generated, but you can create as many keys as you want. To create a new key, all you need to do, create new secret key, and it will give you a key which you need to copy and put it in Notepad or somewhere so that we can use that in the Postman. One thing that you need to know, this OpenAI API will give you a certain amount of usage. Beyond that, you need to pay. They will give you $18 of free credit. So here I have already utilized 0.01 of my $18 credit. And this credit will expire on 1st April 2023. So I have my API key. What I need to do, I need to go to the documentation and I need to go to a section called making request. And this is what I need to know. It's going to be a post request. And this is the URL. So I'll open my Postman and I already have this request stored here. So the first thing is this URL, which is http://api.open.com/v1/completions. So I'll copy that and I'll paste it here. You need two headers. One is content type and one is authorization. Here is my content type, which is application JSON. And in the authorization, I have already used a bearer token, and this is my token. This is my API key. And then this is the body. This is my body here. So in the body, I can put this one here. And let's make it, this is the body. And then if I click on send, it will give me the response. The response is here, I'm asking, say this is a test and this is indeed a test. That's the response. I can make the max token a little more, which is let's say 1000, and then send another request, and then it's going to send me the response. So let's say, tell me about Canada. And then if I send the request, OpenAI will give me information about Canada. And this is a variable. The max that you can go till, I think, is 2000. You can't go beyond that. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to create this one as a variable for Postman. And the value I'm going to pass is in the question, in the variable question. So now I'm going to my flow and start creating my new flow. So here I am in my flow section. So the first thing that I'll do, I'll create a request. in the request, I'll choose the request that I've created right now. And in the question, I need to pass the value. So here, I'll create a string variable. Inside the string variable, I'll put tell me about Postman. And then this one, this is the value I'm passing to the variable question. And this is from start to this. If it is success, I'm going to pass the success in a select variable. And the thing that I'm interested is this text, which is basically giving me the response from OpenAI. And let's put that in a log file. With that, if I run my request and open the console, I can see the response coming back. Postman is a collection. So it's basically giving me a description of the postman. I can change the question. Tell me about Switzerland. Execute the same thing again. And OpenAI is going to give me some information about Switzerland. So Switzerland is a small landlocked country in Central Europe. So this is the way how you can integrate OpenAI with Postman. So let's make this a little more complicated. This time, I'll be calling two API. In the first API, I'm going to pass a variable, which is basically a country code. And the API is going to give me all the information, including the capital of the country, which I am going to use to ask OpenAI to tell me more about the capital. So let's do that in a new flow. So we'll start again from here. The first thing is that I am going to send a request and I already have API. This is an API where if I pass the country code, let's say IND, which is India, if I pass the country code in this variable called country code, it's going to return me the result. For example, let's log the result and see how it looks like. So I'm going to clear the console and run this. And the response that I'm getting back from this API is this India and the capital is New Delhi. So I'm going to pass this value and ask some question about New Delhi. To do that, I'm going to create here. I'm going to pass this one and I'm going to combine text. So in the first text is tell me more about, this is my text, and then this one is value one. So let's see what is the output. I don't need this output anymore. Text is not, this will not work. What I need to do, I need to select a variable which is basically my capital. So that's my capital and then I need to pass that capital to value one. So let's clear that and run. So tell me more about New Delhi. Now I'm going to pass that to my second call, which is basically my OpenAPI call. So here I'm going to pass this one. And in this one, I'm going to pass the output. That's good. From the success, I'm going to select the, not this one. Select. And here I am interested about this text and then print that text here. So let's review what I've done. Here, this is my first API call where I'm passing the country code India. This API call is going to give me all the information about India, including the country code, including the capital, which I am storing here. Then I'm passing that capital value to this value one and a static text, which is tell me more about. And then I'm concatenating these two values. It's basically a string concatenation. So tell me more about the capital, which is New Delhi here. That's the output which I'm passing to my OpenAI call. And OpenAI call is going to give me more about the capital, which is New Delhi. And then this is the place where the value is coming in the text. And then I'm putting that in log. So let's execute that. Let's clear the console and execute. call is still going on, and here is the information. New Delhi is the capital of India. If I change to Canada, let's execute again. So now it should be giving me the capital of Canada, which is Ottawa. If I change it to USA and execute again, it's going to give me information about capital of USA, which is Washington. So this is the way how we can integrate OpenAI with Postman using Postman Flow. If you go to the OpenAI website and click on this examples tab, you will find a lot of options here, which you can literally integrate with Postman. So please let me know which option you are integrating with Postman in the comment section of this video. I'm really interested to know about your use case. So I hope this video is helpful. Please hit the like icon and share, and please subscribe to my channel to get update about all my upcoming videos. Till then, stay safe. Goodbye. Thank you.